Hello everybody and welcome back to my channel. And today's video is about the very infamous Belgian Malinois. As you can see, Ranger, we got him to Assam around 2 months back and he's doing extremely well. He's very, very intelligent and energetic. He plays a lot and he's very, very suspicious in nature, no doubt. So anybody who wants to get a Belgian Malinois, there are a few things you have to be prepared. And people who are thinking of getting a Malinois for the first time, who have no experience with dogs, it's a big, big no for them. Because they are a totally different kind of breed. So today I would like to tell you guys what are the few things you need to take care of before owning a Belgian Malinois. Well, as you can see, Ranger, definitely they are not an apartment pet. They need a big space to move around since they're very energetic and they are definitely not an apartment dog. I have seen quite a few people who are posting videos and pictures making them stay in apartments, but I'm sure they are taking enough care for them, taking them for long walks, playing around, playing with them in the park and giving them enough time. So the first thing I would like to tell you guys is the Malinois are definitely not an apartment dog. We have kept him in our farm. We personally stay in an apartment in Guwahati, but we have not kept him in the apartment since he needs a lot of space to move around, jump around, play around. So we have kept him in the farm where he's having a good time. Well, another important thing about the Malinois are they are definitely not a backyard dog. You need to give enough time to them. I've seen many people who have dogs who tie them in their backyard and occasionally take them for walks, but this Malinois are definitely not that kind of dog. They need a lot of time from the owner. We should spend at least 3 to 4 hours with them every day so that they can interact with you, because their life revolves around you. The Malinois are very, very attached to the owners. So at least you need to spend 3 to 4 hours every day with them, talk to them, interact with them. So that's very important. If you do not have the time, I mean, at least 3 to 4 hours every day to spend with them, please, please do not get them, get a Malinois for yourself. Because if you do not spend time with them, just unlike the other dogs where most of the people tie them in the backyard and take them for long walks occasionally. But this Malinois, they need everyday time. I mean, 3 to 4 hours every day. So unless and until you are prepared to spend at least 3 to 4 hours every day with a Malinois, please do not get them. Otherwise, they would go into depression and, you know, it would be very, very sad. So I would request everybody who are thinking of getting a Malinois, please make sure you can spend at least 3 to 4 hours every day with them. Another important thing I would like to share with you guys is that the Malinois are basically guard dogs. So you definitely need to train them. Otherwise, they might create problems. So obedience and training is a must for the Malinois. I would like to cite an example out here. There is a Malinois whose name is Cairo, and he is a member of the American SEAL Team 6 of the American military. And this Malinois, whose name is Cairo, played a very, very crucial and critical role in finding and catching Osama bin Laden. We all know who Osama bin Laden is, the big terrorist of the millennium, of the 21st century. So to catch him, this Malinois was trained so that, you know, he can come along with the American military force who is a member of the SEAL Team 6. So you can understand how intelligent and active they are. So a proper training is a must, because, you know, if you do not train a Malinois, it will be like, you know, wasting his energy, wasting his intelligence. So if you are trying to get a Malinois, please make sure to make him well trained so that you can get the maximum output from such a beautiful breed. You can start with some basic commands like sit, stand, stay, down, up, right, left. These are some basic commands: eat, sleep. So, you know, so once you trained him, he is very obedient. So anybody who wants to get a Malinois, please make sure you make him well trained so that you can get maximum output from such a beautiful breed. Well, another example of the Belgian Melanoma becoming indispensable of the American military force is that a Melanoma was trained to catch the very notorious al-Baghdadi, who was an ISIS member, who was a terrorist of the ISIS. So al-Baghdadi was found and caught by a Belgian Melanoma along with the American army. So you can understand how intelligent and courageous and active they are. And there's one more information I would like to share about the Melanoma. Are they are a very good pain taker. They will not let you know they are in pain. They can jump up to 15 feet height. They can climb trees, they can walk on ropes. So, you know, if you train them, they can do anything possible. Like they can swim for hours. So, these Melanomas are very good pain taker. They won't let you know they are in pain. Anybody who has a Melanoma, you need to be very careful when you're training them, because sometimes even if they have an injury, they won't let you know that they are in pain and that they have an injury. So, it's very important for the owners who have a Melanoma to check time and again. Oh, there he is. Ranger, he's watching me in the video. He's very relaxed. So whenever I'm near him, he's very relaxed. He's sleeping, so I'm sleeping along with him. So it's very important to check them every time they are outside playing around with you. Whether they are in pain. So what I would like to say is, anybody who has a Melanoma, please take proper care of them when they are playing around, because they won't let you know if they are in pain. The another information which I would like to share with you guys is that, how do you know whether you have a pure Melanoma breed? Because since they are a shepherd dog, sometimes many people confuse them with a German shepherd, but they are not German shepherd. They are Belgian Melanoma, and nobody can replace them. So how do you know whether you're buying a pure breed? The first and foremost thing which I would like to tell you is, check the coat of the breed. The universal color is a fawn color, which Ranger is. Ranger is fawn color, and sometimes this fawn color gets a little darker. It looks like mahogany, and they are very thick coated. And there are other Melanomas as well, like black, brown and gray, which are very rare. But what we have, the coat of Ranger, that is fawn color, that is a universal color. You won't get confused if you have a fawn color, if you're getting a fawn color Melanoma. And they have a black mask, as you can see. There he is. They have a black mask with black ears, which distinguishes them from other breeds. So when you have a Melanoma, they usually have a black mask. I mean, this face part will be black, and then they will have black ears, and the body will be fawn color to dark mahogany, with some traits of black as well. That's how they look, and they are usually square shaped. And Ranger is hardly 4 months old. He's still a baby, but he's well grown. He's very strong. They have a very good body structure. They look very strong, and they have very questionable eyes. You know, when you look at them, their eyes look as if they are questioning you. They are very curious. They look at you with so much of curiosity, and usually they have brown eyes, just like the Belgian chocolate. You know how the Belgian chocolate color is, so the eyes are usually that color. So when you're buying a Belgian Melanoma, when you're adopting a Belgian Melanoma, make sure of the coat, whether he is fawn color and dark mahogany, having a total black mask, the nose part, the mouth, and around the eyes, it will be totally black with black ears. So that's how a pure Belgian Melanoma looks like. Now let us talk about the diet and nutrition of a Melanoma. I have told time and again that they are very energetic, they are very playful, and they need a lot of energy, hence they need a lot of energy. So guys who want to adopt a Melanoma, they have to be very, very careful about the nutrition and diet part of it. What we are feeding Ranger is, we give him milk in the morning. He loves milk, and we give him that regular dog food, which is Royal Canine or Pedigree. We change the food occasionally so that he doesn't get bored. Then water, there has to be constant water around him, because they drink a lot of water. Melanie was drinking a lot of water. So you need to keep a big bowl of water around them all the time because they drink a lot of water. And they need a very high calorie diet because since they are very playful, they are very energetic, they need a lot of energy to move around. So you have to be very careful in giving them a proper diet. Definitely, it's a high calorie diet with lot of chicken and protein and lots of vegetables. So we feed him thrice a day. Four times a day. That is in the morning milk. Which sometimes he doesn't like biscuits and all. He likes dog food, Pedigree, Royal Canine. And then around 10 o'clock, we give him rice and chicken with lots of vegetables. The same in the afternoon and also in the evening. And in between, we give him treats when he's moving around with us. He's playing around. We give him treats. So anybody who wants to get a Melanoa, you just learn that they need a high calorie diet with lots of protein, vegetables. A high calorie diet. That's it. Okay, another important thing is regarding their health. Melanoas are extremely strong and healthy dogs. They usually do not get sick, but as a precaution, you should always get them well vaccinated about the 7 and 9 diseases which the dogs usually get. When we got Ranger, he was already vaccinated, and we have also vaccinated him with anti-rabies, so that even most of the time he's tied up out here because we do not have a well fenced place right now. So we do take him for walks and untie him when nobody's around. So please, Ranger. So it's very important for your for the owners to get your dog vaccinated, especially when you have a Melanoa, because they are very sharp. They won't tolerate strangers. So if they get untied by mistake, they are definitely going to bite by the other people around. So regarding their health, it's very important for the owner to get them vaccinated. Well, there is another short video coming up, Ranger getting vaccinated yesterday. It's a very funny scene when Ranger gets an injection. So there's a short video coming up after this. Ranger had loose motions few days back. Probably he had some indigestion due to cold here. So he had loose motion, and the vet had come to our farm to give him an injection. And it was a very funny sight to see the way he reacted. So we have recorded the video, and it's very important. One more thing, it's very important for the owners to get your pet dewormed. No matter how hygienic food we give and how cleanliness we maintain, dogs have a habit of licking everywhere, you know, putting their mouth everywhere. They will lick you everywhere. They tend to kiss you. This is what Ranger is doing right now. Look at his paws. They are huge, as big as a tiger. He has huge paws and they are very strong. So what I'm trying to say is get your dog dewormed every 2 months, so that your dog is free from worms. So a short video is coming up where Ranger is getting an injection, and that's very funny. So have a look. So there's somebody in the farm, so Ranger has started to mark. So let's end the video here. Hope you guys enjoyed my video. And thank you so much.